Hello, welcome everyone. This is Jordan Berry, instructional designer at Hack, and this video is designed to give you an overview of how to set up your YouTube account, upload a video to YouTube, and share that link out to students in D2L. Now, this is assuming that you've already had a video recorded, either a Zoom session or a screencast that you've created, and we're going to look at how to get that video uploaded to YouTube and share it out with the students. So the first thing that you're going to want to do is log into your MyHack account. Once you're in your MyHack account, you'll see on the left-hand side an option that's titled Google Apps for Education. Go ahead and hit that and open it up, and you're going to select YouTube. Now, once you're in YouTube, you're going to go to the top right corner. You may or may not already be signed in, but you're going to want to make sure that you're signed in with your @hack.edu account. So for me, I'm going to sign in. And in this situation, I'm signing in with a personal account because I've already gone through this setup process in my Hack account, and I want to show you the steps of how to get started. So when you log in, you're going to use your Hack email address and the same password that you use to log into my Hack. Once you're logged in, the first thing you're going to want to do is actually verify your YouTube account. You'll need to do this because YouTube only allows you to upload videos that are less than 15 minutes long if you haven't verified your account. So to upload longer videos, you'll need to verify your Google account by going to www.youtube.com/verify and go through this process here. Once you do that, you'll be able to upload videos as long as you please. www.youtube.com/verify. And once you do this, you're going to have to go through this process of verifying your account. You can have them call you with an automated message that'll give you this certain account number that you'll need to input, or you can text the verification code. So you have to put in your cell phone number and submit. Once you get that text, you'll have to put in your verification number and submit. And now your account is verified and you'll be able to upload very large and long videos. And go ahead and hit continue. And that's it. Now you can navigate back to www.youtube.com and we'll continue uploading our video from there. All right, so once you're in and you're sure you're in the right email address, you're going to click in the top right corner this little icon with the plus symbol. Okay, this is where you're going to click and upload a video. So now a pop-up's going to appear and ask you to get started. You're going to go ahead and go through this process and you're going to select the option on the left. Okay, we can skip all this process now and scroll all the way down to the bottom for now, and we can set it up later. All right, so once you're in this section, you have an option of how to start uploading a video. You can click Upload Video in the center, or you can hit this little icon in the top right corner. I would suggest using this little icon in the top right corner just to get familiar with using that option. So here we are, we're going to click it and click Upload Video. So here we are, we're going to click Got It, and we're going to be prompted to select our file. So we're going to click Select File, and we're going to find that video that we want to upload. Now I'm going to use the example of a Zoom session that's been recorded, and to find that, you're going to click on the Documents section on the left-hand sidebar, and you're going to click the Zoom folder. Now, Zoom automatically creates a new folder for every session that you record. So you're going to go in and you're going to pick your recording that you'd like. And you'll know that it's a video file because it'll be titled with a .mp4 at the end of it. All right, so typically Zoom's going to name these files Zoom_0 and .mp4 as a video. So go ahead and select that video file and let YouTube do its thing. All right, now here you're going to give your video a title. Make sure it's a clear title so that your students know exactly what they're looking at when they enter the video. And you can give it a description if you'd like. And you'll notice that YouTube already provides you a link that you can share out to students. And we're going to go ahead and click this little icon right here that looks like two pieces of paper. And that's to copy the video link. So I'm going to go ahead and click that. And now my video link is copied. All right, we're going to just keep that there in the background because we're going to use that link to share out into D2L. So I'm going to scroll down here. And we're going to make sure that we select that the audience for our video is not made for kids. And we're going to click next. All right, we can skip this screen for now. We don't need to bother with that. And this is where you're going to choose your privacy or visibility options. For me, I'm going to click public because I want everyone to be able to access this and use this information. If you want, you can click unlisted, which means that only people with the YouTube link can access the video. Okay, next you're going to hit publish. So you'll see that this video is processing now, and we're going to now jump into our D2L shell to paste that link for students. So we'll go back up to My Hack Portal, and we'll click our Brightspace D2L option. We're going to pick the class that we want to get into. And once we're in our class, we're going to select the content area. All right, so now that you're in the content area, you're going to pick the module that you want to put the video into. So on the left-hand side, you should have created a module. If you haven't yet already, you can click into this box and add another module if you'd like, or add a first module if you'd like. For now, I'm going to use my week one. And we're going to go in the main content area, and we're going to click new. And we're going to say create a link, because we have a YouTube link. Now this section is going to pop up. And you're going to give this video a title, one that the students can understand. And we're going to go to this URL bar and right click and paste. Now we're going to hit create. So you'll notice that your video is now uploaded into the content area. If you go back to your main content area, you'll see that it will show up here. And this is where students will be able to see it. All right, now this may take a little bit of time for this to process and publish, but that's perfectly fine. We can let that run in the background. All right, thanks everyone. I hope you found this useful. If you need any extra help, go ahead and feel free to give us a contact over here at CDI. Thanks so much.